we try to crystallize the whole, various attempts to try to crystallize the whole of TO3A, and also the TO3A bound to 5S RNA. When I talked about the binding, there's a 42 sediment, 42S particle and the 7S particle, sedimentation particle, which are found in the ribosome. These are storage proteins with TO3A. And so we try to crystallize the 7S particle, 42 seemed to be too big, and failed over many years. Louise Ferrel, who now joins the group, tried for a long time. In the meantime, Daniela Rhodes, Kyoshi, and a guy in the lab had shown as another transcription factor, SMI-five, which is involved in yeast mating type, which is on HOND nuclease. They had found that they'd shown that the DNA binding domain is enough to carry this very large protein to its target. And so it was absolutely essential. This was, and other people began to show similar things. So these were a new class of DNA binding domains. And that's where the zinc fingers are. And the numbers began to mount. Typically, proteins contain groups of fingers, maybe, but usually not more than three or four in any one run. But there is a protein called X-fin, which has 37 zinc fingers. It's involved in Xenopus, but it's divided up into groups of seven groups, six or seven groups, I've forgotten now, which the discoverer is called hands, you see. It's a group of hands. Nobody knows what that does. So the numbers are growing. But I want to return to other so-called zinc fingers and get them out of the way. Chambon in France and Ron Evans at the Salk were looking at a certain class of enzymes, of transcription factors involved in switching on nuclear transcription factors. These are nuclear genes, and these are ligand driven. These are steroid and thyroid hormones, estrogen, and they found that the sequence contained, you had things in the sequence looked like zinc fingers, but they had a fold about the right shape. Instead of two cysteines and two histidines, they had four cysteines. So they, as I said, Ron Evans didn't know enough chemistry, but I think he read my paper and he thought it must be a zinc finger, you see. And Chambon tried to disprove that these things contain zinc by replacing the two cysteines by two histidines. And of course the thing didn't fold up because it didn't have the right geometry, but it was a long story. Anyway, it turned out this is what they called class two zinc fingers, and they are C4, four cysteines. But it turned out they're not like fingers at all, because they do fold up. They have two helices in them. One helix is the recognition helix. That's like TF3A. The other helix is a kind of strut. But they operate as dimers, and they bind to dimeric DNA sites. So they belong to a quite different category. And they're not, although they use zinc, and it turned out there are many other protein designs which involve zinc, use zinc to fold up. And the reason why they use zinc is very obvious. In the nucleus, which is a strong reducing agent, you can't use SS bridges. So zinc is used to help fold up proteins. Zinc is the next commonest metal to iron in the nucleus. And in fact, I was able to suggest a diagnosis for a disease. I kept being invited to meetings, you see, because zinc, and turned out there's a lot of people working in bio inorganic chemistry. And in one meeting, I heard about an Egyptian doctor called Prasad, who in the 1950s worked in Iraq. And he found that certain young men suffered from not passing through puberty properly. Girls were inaccessible because of the culture, And I heard this from somebody working at Georgia Tech at a meeting, and he said that when they brought up rats, female rats, on a zinc deficient diet, they could never breed, never could ovulate. And it was obvious what it was. They need zinc to fold up the nuclear receptor program. They need, as you haven't had the zinc, they can't have a new estrogen receptor, and they don't pass through puberty. The rats don't, the female rats don't develop, don't mature. And that was happening in Iraq. And the reason it's happening in Iraq is that the soil is very much, it's a clay soil. It's in the marsh areas of Iraq. It's very clean, the so-called marshes, which Saddam tried to drain, or did drain. And so these clay like absorb minerals, and they're zinc deficient. And so they tested that, and they are zinc deficient. So like another nice little story, how this throws light on a disease. So zinc is an essential part of the diet, as we all know that, but now we know why. And certainly it's essential for passing through puberty.